We just announced some new updates and new features to Reflect, so I'm going to quickly cover them in this video and just show you what's new. So first of all, and probably the most important, we have the new backlink picker. The backlink picker is what shows up when you type double brackets. And the first few notes are auto suggestions, and then you can, of course, type whatever you want after that, and the note will show up. So first off, when I just type the brackets now, we've heavily improved the ordering and the suggestions of these. So these are the notes that I've most recently been working on this morning. And then as I type, so let's say maybe I'm looking for a list of my articles. I could type in article. And here, another update, you see that article is now bolded in the suggestion so that it's much easier to see what you are searching for. And again, the ordering is improved. Similarly, if I type in ideas or idea, I get a list of everything that I've been working on with my ideas. So those are the main updates there, the improved UI, including the bolding and the improved ordering and sorting. I also want to mention too, with the backlink picker, you can pull up relative dates. So for example, I could say Thursday, and it gives me this Thursday, next Thursday, last Thursday. I could also type in 1 week from now. I could type in 1 week ago. And it will just add those dates in there and add the backlink to that day. Let's go on to number two. So this is a quick one. We've added the forward and back buttons to the desktop and web app and also the iPad app. Now, you can, of course, always go forward and back using the command and the open and closing brackets. I think that's what most people do. But this was one of our most requested features, so we've added the toggle buttons, and it was particularly requested on the iPad app, so look for it there as well. All right, and then toggling tasks and checklists on mobile. Actually, I should probably show this to you. Okay, here, just for the sake of simplicity, I pulled in a screenshot of our mobile app, and you can see this button here will now toggle between the checklist items, tasks, and a bullet list. So you can just keep tapping that, and it will toggle between the three. Okay, really quickly, I'm going to just read through some of the other smaller updates that we have. I won't go into them in detail or show them. We've added support for custom protocols, for example, things by typing this. We have introduced task creation via the API using the plus sign, which, by the way, you can just kind of use anywhere in the app and it will create a task as well. We've improved the performance for pages with a lot of incoming backlinks. So if you're someone that has an immense number of backlinks, you'll notice much better performance there. We resolved a critical mobile editing bug. So if you've been experiencing a bug on the mobile app, that should now be fixed. We've improved the handling of remote images. They now re-upload automatically when dragged in from a browser. We implemented the scroll bars in dark mode. I'm, of course, in light mode right now, so you can't see that. We've enhanced the meeting sorting across multiple calendars, adjusted the positioning of the pop-up account menu when resizing the sidebars here. And we fixed an aliasing issue that was causing duplicate entries. So that was annoying you. That should now be fixed. So that's pretty much everything that we've got to release right now. And then if you're curious what we are working on next, a lot with the mobile app. So we are going to be adding tasks to the mobile app. That should be coming. There's going to be a major performance update that will really just improve everything. And we're also in the process of getting the mobile app officially added to the App Store so that you won't see that pesky test flight link anymore when signing up. That's what we've got going. If you've got any questions about what's coming up or anything we just released, let me know in the comments and I'll try and respond.